What's up, guys? Working on another build here today in the shop. This time it's Bama tuning technician Justin and his beautiful 13 GT behind me here. Now, Justin, tell us a little bit about your experience and some of the mods going on with the car.
So far, it's got some JBA long tube headers, off-road exhaust, 410 gears, and a Bama tune. Currently, the car runs about 1230s at the track on street tires.
We've got some parts that should definitely help you out with that today. And guys, we're gonna be getting to work on his car very soon. But of course, if you wanna see more of these builds, you should know what to do by now. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, American Muscle Videos, for more of this great Mustang content. But now, ready to get to work, brother?
Absolutely.
All right, let's do it. Well, guys, here it is. We're doing the Cobra Jet intake manifold on Justin's GT, along with the big monoblade throttle body. Some parts, again, I have some familiarity with. These parts absolutely rock. And Justin, I know you're stoked about getting these things on. What are you most looking forward to?
Last time I went out to the track, you know, my car really fell short, the high RPMs. I couldn't make it through the traps in fourth gear without having to push a clutch in and roll through. I'm looking forward to be able to just blast it all the way through, see if it can pick up a little bit of top end power as well.
Absolutely. I definitely saw some good gains, and I'm sure with your long tubes, so I'm guessing gains should be huge with this thing. Any expectations number-wise?
Hopefully between 430, 440. Anywhere in there, I'll be super happy.
Fantastic. Now, obviously, guys, the install itself really isn't that bad. I mean, the only part that really will give you any extra work is repinning the ECU or the throttle body harness here, since we are switching to a GT500 style throttle body. Really a big piece of cake, though, once you get a repinning tool or something like that, and Justin made short work of that. So we're gonna keep working on this thing, get it buttoned up, but Justin, white GT, Cobra Jet setup, did we just become best friends?
I think so.
All right. All right, guys, so Justin and I are just finished up installing the last piece of the puzzle here today. That's the Ford Racing cold air intake. That, of course, is designed to work with the Cobra Jet setup. It looks awesome under the hood, but now it's time to make some power. So we're gonna move this thing over to the dyno jet. Justin and his team at Bama Performance are gonna write a tune for this thing, and it's time to rock and roll. You ready, man?
Let's do it.
Well, guys, Justin just finished up making a few runs here with his 2013 GT with the Cobra Jet setup installed. It certainly sounded nasty, and I think the results are speaking for themselves. Car is now making 433 horsepower, 381 pound-feet of torque, a nice little gain, 30 peak horsepower over his baseline numbers, and gains as much as 42 horsepower, 25 pound-feet of torque under the curve. A lot of those gains coming in the top end, you gotta like what you see, right?
Absolutely.
Nice.
I think that the upper RPM range is gonna get me through the traps the way I want. I can stay in fourth gear instead of trying to shift to fifth. And, you know, the up top power is definitely an added plus.
Absolutely, and I think a lot of people should know this about the Cobra Jet setup. I mean, it's really a win-win. You're getting all those big top end gains, but unlike the Boss manifold, you're not sacrificing a ton of low end power. But speak to me a little bit about the tuning process. I saw you and Paul out here working on things.
Paul and I spent a lot of time developing this tune specifically for this car with this combination. The monoblade throttle body sometimes gives some drivability issues, so we spent a lot of time getting that smoothed out. It's got a nice smooth idle. The throttle action is very smooth and progressive. There's no choppiness to it.
So very nice drivability is what you're telling
Absolutely.
Me then. So I think there's only really one way to test drivability. It's not really something you can show on a dyno. So what do you say we get this thing unstrapped, we hit the streets and see how it does?
Let's do it.
All right, so we're out in Justin's car. Here is 2013 GT with the Cobra Jet setup. Now, full disclosure, guys, middle of the winter time here in the Northeast. It's 20 degrees outside. Salt and ice all over the road, so obviously we won't be doing any gnarly first through fourth top end pulls today, but we're just really getting the feel of the drivability. And so far, Justin, what's your impression?
I think it's smooth as butter. It's everything I hope for, maybe a little bit more than I even expected.
Yeah, you said pulling out of the parking lot, it's almost even better than your stock setup, correct?
Yes, absolutely. Like you said, we can't really go full throttle pulls, but testing the drivability, it's definitely impressive.
The car sounds good though, man. I like it from the inside. It sounds,
totally different from the inside.
It sounds awesome.
So everybody's like, that car is ferociously loud. I'm like, yeah, I know, it's awesome. Dude, it's smooth. It really is.
That's awesome, man. Well, I'd say it pulls really hard. I mean, what was that? Was probably what, $5,000 or $6,000?
Yeah,
not 50, even
5,500.
So if you were to like crack off a downshift here or there, I mean, there's no throttle hang or anything like that.
No, it you know, it drops back down to the desired idle almost instantly.
That's always important too. I know a lot of people get worried with the big mono blades. There's going to be a lot of throttle hang, a lot of lag, but you're not seeing any of that.
None of that at all.
And it still pulls hard as ever. So there you go, guys. Obviously, Justin stoked on his Cobra Jet setup, as he should be. The car is making good power, pulling strong, and driving great. So
absolutely.
There you go. So we'll be able to follow Justin when he heads to the track so we can actually see if he's improved on his low 12-second time slips. But in the meantime, for all things Mustang, keep it right here at AmericanMuscle.com.